Tonight focuses on gambling. It's coming to Pennsylvania. But as Nidia Hahn reports tonight, along with slots comes controversy about so-called comp or reward cards.
When the Pennsylvania slot parlors open, count on seeing a lot of these reward cards floating around.
As you play, you stick your card in the machine, and it gives you comp points back.
Bill Kearney, a former gambling addict, says the problem is those comp points lead some people into problems.
That's their bait to get you in. That's what justifies, again, your game, your spending.
He says the more you spend, the more comps you get, and the more hooked on gambling you become.
The problem is that because you're getting something, you won't feel the pain.
Last year, Pennsylvania State Representative Paul Clymer proposed a bill that would require casino operators to send monthly statements to all reward card holders, something Kearney strongly supports.
This would include your amount of time you played, how much you won, how much you lost.
Supporters hope the constant reminder would help people catch a gambling problem before it gets out of control.
The person who is spending doesn't realize how much they're spending. They're being treated royally by the casino people. They're getting these rewards, and it's all because they're losing money.
What do consumers have to say?
I think it would be better for the consumer if they had a monthly statement so they could budget themselves better.
Maybe they would actually see what they're losing.
Action News has obtained a proposal by Donald Trump's developer, which says his casino will consider mailing reward card statements to these nearby Philadelphia zip codes on a quarterly basis. Kearney says that's a start, but not nearly enough.
By the time they realize they got a problem, they won't be able to stop.
When Action News asked the casinos about monthly statements, they had no comment. Meantime, House Bill 1245, which would have mandated monthly statements, ended up in a split vote and did not pass. I'm Nidia Hahn, Channel 6, Action News.
Back in my life, you know why? Because I've observed firsthand what would seem to different kinds of people that are addicted to gambling, what we would call degenerates. I've noticed there's one thing that makes all of them the same. You know what that is?
Yes. They're all looking to lose.
I am an ex-casino gambling degenerate. At the peak of my high, you could have came into the casino and stuck a gun to my head. I'd say, pull the trigger. I'm not leaving.
New today at 4:30, Pennsylvania lawmakers postponed action today on legalizing table games in Pennsylvania's casinos. Governor Ed Rendell is frustrated. The issue is still unresolved, and he warns there could be more program cuts and layoffs without that legislation. And now, a provision in the bill to extend lines of credit to gamblers is drawing fire. Eyewitness News reporter Jim Osman is live in the news center with all the details on this one. Jim.
Hi, Susan. It's a reality for some gamblers. You've maxed out the credit cards, drained your debit card, and turned to the house for a little help.
Gamblers exhausting their own debit and credit cards could turn to the casino. The casino would have the option to offer a credit line to gamblers. Bill Kearney, who lost everything he had because of his gambling habit at Atlantic City casinos, remembers using credit and how he felt.
Well, I had no other choice because I'm in what's called the chase now. Okay, I'm trying to win back my losses.
Kearney wants the casinos, if they are allowed to issue credit, to be forced to issue gambler statements detailing how much they borrowed and what they've won or lost. He says he wants gamblers to be faced with what financial damage they could be causing to their families, because he understands how out of control the habit can get.
You're up against a wall. You're going to borrow, beg, steal.
Understand.
No, Glenn, you don't understand.
Well, I've been reading up about this. First thing you got to do is admit it to yourself.
You got things wrong.
If you just say it.
I don't have a gambling problem.
Do you think I'm an idiot?
I know I've not been here for you lately, but things are different now. Right, you got to trust me, please. I have a financial problem.
Sands Casino Resort Bethlehem will open its doors on Friday.
Some are betting on some serious fun, of course, while others say having a casino here poses a serious problem. WFMZ's Jocelyn Mose has the story.
Maybe it was the glittering neon lights or the ringing bells of slot machines that first lured Bill Kearney into an Atlantic City casino in the early 80s. But it was the possibility of getting rich quick that kept him there.
Within 6 months, I lost all the money that I had. And then in the next year to 2 years, I was in what's called the chase, trying to win it back.
Kearney says he eventually beat the house and kicked the habit. Today, he speaks out against gaming.
The casinos are operating like amusement parks with no safety belts or cages. There is nothing in that industry that is going to stop someone from becoming what I once was.
I'd lost within 6 months over $1 million in cash and whatever money I could borrow, steal, rob. And then I went into the credit system where you can borrow money from the casino in the form of markers. You know, if you take money out of the casino, they don't charge you interest. So why wouldn't I take it from them? But unfortunately, once you start taking out the credit, you're doomed. It's over. My wife had no idea. She wasn't ignorant. She wasn't stupid. She trusted me. The sheriff came to the door with a, you know, handed her a writ. We have to write down what's in the home. We have to write down all the things because there's going to be a sheriff sale because I was being sued by the casinos. She was just a basket case by now. The following week, I was in the casino gambling, and she walked in. And she says, you got to come home. You got to get out of here. You have to come right now. The pit boys came over and I said, look, you got two things. Either I leave or you get her out of here. He says, that's your wife? I said, she could be a hooker. I don't know. Get her out of here.
They've come to Pennsylvania and along with them, something called casino credit. If you're short on cash to buy chips, the casino will give you a line of credit so you can play on.
Casinos call it a convenient service. Others call it downright dangerous. KD investigator Andy Sheehan is here now with what he's uncovered. Andy.
Well, Rick, under table games legislation, you could be eligible for tens of thousands of dollars of interest-free credit from the casinos. The casinos say this credit is a matter of convenience for their clients, but one gambling addict turned anti-gambling advocate says casino credit is a slippery slope.
In the 1980s, Bill Kearney was a rich man until he was seduced by the allure of the Atlantic City casinos.
When you walk into those buildings, they're glamorous. There's no windows, there's no clocks. They're open 24/7. They're serving free booze.
Never before a gambler, Kearney started with $5 a hand blackjack, but soon found himself at the casinos round the clock with the big boys at the baccarat tables compulsively burning through his fortune.
Went through my money, then the money I could borrow from the banks, the money I could get off my credit cards. And after I exhausted every means of funding my addiction from my own end is when I went to credit with the casinos.
He blames himself, but says he was helped along the way by the availability of interest-free credit offered by the casinos, something now available to gamblers in Pennsylvania as part of the table games legislation. Kearney, who today keeps a scrapbook of all his counter checks from the casinos, and a letter from Caesar's Palace saying he owes them more than $400,000. He says others will follow in his footsteps.
When they get into the credit, a good percentage of people are going to go south. And when they go south, remember, it's not just the gambler who gets hurt. It's his loved ones. Could be his parents. Could be his sisters and his spouses. Could be his children, his grandchildren.
Do with $5?
Buy a bullet and rent a gun.
Let's see how you do against 3 games.
Sure you don't want to save a few bucks for the buffet? Whoa, I am on fire. Well, why don't you give me half the money you were going to bet? Then we'll go out back, I'll kick you in the nuts, and we'll call it a day.